In this video, we'll take a look at Live's mixer section, an essential part of Live's interface for mixing your music. Live's mixer can be found in the session view. You can switch between the arrangement and session views using the toggle in the top right, or using the tab key. If the mixer isn't already visible, you can hide and show it by clicking the button labeled M in the bottom right of the session view. The mixer allows you to adjust tracks' volumes, pan sounds to the left or right, and make use of return tracks. Each track has a volume slider which you can drag up and down to regulate the track volume. Next to the volume slider is the pan dial, which you can use to pan sounds to the left or the right. You can mute, solo, and record arm tracks using the buttons below the pan dial. The track activator mutes an individual track. The solo button will solo a single track, so you can hear only that track in isolation. If you would like to record MIDI or audio into respective tracks, you can toggle the record arm button. When it's red, a track is armed for recording. Above the volume slider are the send dials, which control the amount of audio that gets sent to the return tracks. For example, in the case of return track A, we have a reverb. By adjusting the send A dial on a track, you can send the audio to be processed by the reverb in return track A. Within the volume display, you can see the peak and RMS values of the audio input. The peak meters show sudden changes in level, while the RMS meters give a better impression of the loudness. The peak levels are displayed as green lines, and the RMS levels are displayed beneath. Clicking on the Show Hide CPU Meter Section selector in the Session View's Mixer section will open a per-track CPU metering section. Each track shows a CPU meter with six rectangles that light up to indicate the relative impact of that track on the CPU level of the current set. Freezing or removing devices from the track with the largest impact will usually reduce the CPU load.